storyteller somehow. I grew up in a family where I was the eldest from my mom's side.
So I
have two younger sisters.
Sure.
And always had to keep them entertained. So we'd hire a lot of movies. So my love for watching movies comes from spending time with my family. And then I got into art quite early when I was still young. Well, I mean, I started presenting for KTV when I was in grade 9.
Grade 9?
Yeah, so that was my introduction to being in front of camera.
Okay.
On a professional kind of level. Before that, I did act in one or two SMC dramas.
Okay.
But I was very young, I was way younger. So I was about, let's say, 12 years old. I mean, you know, when you're young and you're on a set, it doesn't feel like you're on a set because you don't know what it is.
Uh-huh.
You know, for me, I didn't actually see the size of what we were doing or the scale of the production that we were actually on. You know, I just love being on set and I love being around people. And I was just fascinated by the camera and I was fascinated by the people behind the scenes, you know.
Okay.
So when I got into KTV, I was very much already aware of the industry, and between myself and two other presenters, we started writing short films and shooting concepts. So for me to find myself falling in love with art just means I took my father's hand. So even once I got into National School of the Arts where I majored in art, I just kind of gravitated towards photography and gravitated towards anything that was kind of film related.
Okay.
So, you know, we didn't grow up having to stick to anything that our parents or society dictated to us. We just followed our hearts really, and both our parents were really
supportive
of whatever decision we wanted to make. My dad was into art, fine art, and he also opened one of the first few black agencies in this country, called Black Gold, and he would do like print campaigns and stuff like that, you know. So he was always in the advertising industry, he was always into art, always into photography. He owned a couple of salons in Tembisa and in the Bobo as well. So my dad was a very much entrepreneur.
Yeah, he was more business minded.
Exactly, yeah. I like to challenge myself.
Something new.
Yeah. I like to try out different things. You know, already like Jacob's Cross, Joseph H, The Lab, like all of those shows are completely different. None of them are similar.
Uh-huh. That's true. That's very nice.
Yeah. So it was just about like embracing new experiences and taking on new work.
Okay.
Well, I mean, you know, while I was shooting Happiness is a four-letter word, I wasn't aware that it was a big movie. I didn't make it a big movie. I just made it a project that I would do my absolute best to deliver the best product that I could do. You know, the response and how people received it and how the South African audience responded to it was absolutely amazing. The team behind it, my producers, Janae, Helena, Bongi, my cinematographer, Lance, the actresses, Lenata, Mawab, Zakani, like, it just worked out, you know. I mean, it didn't just work out, it worked out because we wanted it to work out, and it was literally like divine intervention and God's hand. So as my first movie, I'm completely humbled by the fact that it was so well received, and I look forward to making many more. You know, the thing about it is, I don't work for awards because I've won awards and some I didn't win, and the ones I've won I forget about and some I remember. So I don't clear my work for awards. And for me, the most important thing is to stay true to whatever project I tackle and to give it like everything that I've got to make sure that I can deliver even beyond my own limitations. So that nomination was an absolute blessing. But as I said to you, I don't work to for that kind of recognition. I just work to be the best, to be the best version of myself. You know, for me, I've always been vocal and passionate about opening up the industry, about getting fresh young talent in, about giving exposure to really talented actors who are not given the opportunity to break in. Beyond the people in front of cameras, and people also behind camera, opening up the industry to those individuals who have a real passion for this industry, but are just finding it hard to break in. So being a judge on the final cut for me felt like an opportunity to unearth talent from different parts of South Africa and to get people to see who they are, to get people to hear them, to hear about their dreams, and hopefully give them an opportunity to break into the industry. It's, you know, the team is the people you surround yourself with. People who challenge you, people who will question your decisions because they want you to do better than what you already have in mind. So when I look at my production company now, Siriti, and I look at my partners, around the Zenelli and Kumala and looking at the Webster, and myself, you know, we're four individuals who are really passionate about making a dent in the industry through the kind of work that we produce, through the kind of stories that we're telling, and through taking ownership of the fact that we as South Africans have to tell our own stories to the global viewers, and not only to South Africa, to the world. You know, a hard work, obviously, you know, we always say hard work, but for me the most important thing is attitude. The kind of attitude you have. If you're a hard worker and you have the wrong attitude, no one's going to work with you. The attitude you have towards yourself, how you treat other people around you, your attitude to when you get to work, how you arrive, are you punctual, do you respect your time, do you respect other people's time, are you really giving your best? So like attitude for me.